Hi, Imtiaz.
Hello, people. What's up?
I can see around 14 people live. Please send me a hi so that I know you're there. Hi, Anand. Hi, Ajit. Hi, Amit. Hello people, today we're going to talk about childhood obesity, which is a very 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 important topic which we are going to discuss. Hi Arushi. So before I start, I want to apologize. I was not around for almost 4 to 5 sessions. I lost my auntie, so I couldn't catch up with you guys, and here I am. Now we're going to discuss on some amazing topics. I want you guys to give me a whole lot of topics, you know, which is recently, which you guys are facing, whatever problems y'all are facing, so that, you know, we can address each and every problem. Hi Kuldeep, hi Kona. Before we start, my name is Kejal Sheth. For those who don't know me and those who know me, I am your GOQii health coach and a nutritionist. And today we're going to talk about childhood obesity. Why this is a very common topic. Why is this happening? What's the common cause? Hello everyone. Hi Jay, hi Amol, hi Sunil, hi Kona, hi Srinath, hi Ashish, hello Amit, hello, hi Akshay. Okay, so let's just get going with the topic. So why did I come up with this topic? Okay, so basically what I've been noticing these days, what I see the current trend, it's okay, things, you know, it's life, things happen. Okay, so see, it's a current trend, like nowadays kids these days are around TV, say for around say 7 to 8 hours a day. They sit, they watch TV. Sorry, I was just getting a call. Hi Narendra. They sit at one place, they watch TV, they are in front of the television for hours, they are on their tablets, on iPads. You know, this has become a common, very 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 common trend these days. And while they are sitting, while they are, even while they are studying for hours, the kids have continuously, they have an habit, continuously binge eating something or the other. Okay, anything, be it anything. And moms, to avoid anything, to you know, just avoid any problems, or to avoid the nagging of their kids, they bring in chips, chivdas and ice creams and cakes and chocolates and you know, samosa pav, vada pav and sandwich and whatnot. On the go wali cheez leke aa jaate hai, you know, our moms, they have an habit of doing. So due to this trend, due to this recent complication, that's just become a way of living. But why? Like, what I'm trying to say is, instead of spending so much on these foods, why don't we spend on some other foods, which is a very common problem which has to be addressed right now. Thank you guys, thank you for all your condolences, I accept them all. So let's get going with the topic. We have Arushi talking about, okay, just give me a minute. Arushi is saying, please do a session on causes of belly fat, how to get rid of it, and powerful remedies to reduce it. Amazing, I'll do that for sure very soon. So, you know, it's become an habit. But do you know, it's a very big risk to your child's health. I mean, it's such a big pain. Only and only, see, nowadays, at least if you see, one of the parent has a major health complication like diabetes, blood pressure, cholesterol. So this has become a very very common you know, problem, very very common you know, I would say complication in our routine. So blood pressure and PCOS and all of this is like a very 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 common problem which we as parents are facing. So I thought, I just want to bring up this topic so that you can help all your children around yourself, your own kids, you know, kids living in your family. It needs to be addressed. So it's a big risk, because see, if you are a diabetic, if you have BP, if you have cholesterol, there are more than 70% chances of your child facing it at some point of time. If not because of your genes, then because of your child's lifestyle, because that lifestyle is of course gifted by you. So guys, you need to understand childhood obesity is a big problem, and it will increase the chance of your child to have heart disease, stroke, diabetes, liver, anything and everything. So it's a very big complication. So what you need to do is how we can address this problem. Guys, you need to start early. Whatever it is, you know, the child should have a habit of eating healthy from a earlier life. So, you know, during pregnancy only a mother shouldn't increase more weight. Second thing, during pregnancy only you should start eating all the healthy foods. Second, while you're lactating, you need to have the galactagogues. By galactagogues, I'm not going into science. I simply mean, aisa food khao jo aapko, you know, lactation mein help kare. You know, it helps you, like, for example, just try flax seeds hai, til ke laddu hai. All of these foods, you know, boost your breast milk, and that milk which comes out, which is very beneficial for your child. So whatever the trend is, I agree ki, you know, ye Cheetos or Doritos or ye sab trend mein hai. Try to make all of these foods at home. Simply by saying ki aap whole wheat aur maize flour ka combination karke ghar pe bhi nachos bana sakte ho. You can just bake them. You just don't need to, you know, buy it from market and give it handover packets to them. Nowadays we get healthy food packets also. You know, you can buy makhanas, you can buy oats chivda. You know, keep all of these foods at home. You can even simply do nothing, but you know, you can create like a screen free environment for your child. Just ask your child that they set rules from earlier age, set rules from the start. Aise nahi hai ki, you know, you just do or you're just doing it. Set simple rules. You need to sit with your child and eat food. Aisa nahi hai ki, you know, you are just handing over food to your child and going away. Keep mobiles, tablets, video games, set timings, at least, you know, minimum 1 to 2 hours a day, and that's it. Because what I noticed, the results of children these days, I had a lot of complaints coming in, are going way too low, guys. The environment of what they have, the party life, and you know, they have to go for picnics and all of that sort, what I'm noticing is really bad. Instead of all of that, you know, try to, and you know, engage your child in maybe more of physical activity, maybe aerobic, bone strengthening, maybe skipping a rope, gymnastics, push-ups, anything what you feel like, any form of physical activity where there's a group also involved, so that they also feel that they are not, you know, separated from their friends. Try to create that kind of environment. You do workout with your child, you go swimming, you take your child for swimming, you take your child for some kind of workout. Make it entertaining for them. Even if they like dancing, you dance with them. People have that habit, oh, mom does that, let me also do the same. So you know, whatever it is, you need to understand, if you have complications, it is bound that your child is going to have that. So it's better to start from an early age, from an early start. And instead of giving them packaged food, I would say give them earthy foods. Give them everything from the earth. Avoid the packets, you know. Can you all see me, guys? Am I visible? Please say a yes so that I know you all can see me. I think now I am visible, right? There was some connection issue. Am I visible? Okay, I think yes, people are saying yes. So Gurmeet is asking how to motivate child to eat green veggies and dals. In my child's case, it is he is severely underweight. Okay. So, you know, if you have to eat green leafy vegetables, you need to incorporate that in such a way that your child doesn't come to know. If your child is nagging, if your child is cranky, if he's not eating at all, okay, what you have to do is you have to try to, you know, inculcate it in such a way that your child doesn't, you know about it. So simple ideas like, you know, making like a paneer frankie added to the paneer, so add the spinach to the paneer, or making spinach corn dal, or maybe simply making paneer, mix green broccoli and almond soup, making paratha. Try to feed your child with colors. I hope I am visible, guys. Can you all see me? I think there is some network issue from GOQii. I'm just trying my best to connect it properly. Children are explored to the digital world and forget to play and do physical activities. Exactly. So what is important? It is very important to stay hydrated throughout the day. So try to, give them water in form of maybe infused water instead of an aerated drink when they crave for. Incorporate healthy snacks, instead of ice cream, you can simply give like a Greek yogurt with nuts and seeds to it. Teach your child serving size. Guys, before you teach your child about serving size, you need to teach yourself about serving size. I'll tell you what exactly. Oh, guys, can you all see me? Please tell me yes. Can you all see me? Yeah, you all can see me? Oh, okay. So like I was talking about the serving size. Before you teach your child about the serving size, you need to understand about serving size. Aisa nahi hota hai ki agar aap do roti kha rahe ho, toh aapka bachcha do roti khayega. Guys, you need to understand, you can't be giving your child what you are eating. Your child's tummy is chota. Give only how much your child is hungry and how much your child is craving for. So you can't be just giving, three rotis to your child and say, no, now you have to finish it. And if then you come and crib, oh, mera bachcha sirf ek hi roti khata hai, but pav bhaji mein teen pav khata hai. You can't be doing that. You need to understand what your child likes, how he's going to eat, how he's not going to eat. Okay. It is okay to have a snack size bag of chips. Because it is delicious, your child is going to have that, but you need to control on the serving size. Parents don't want to take kids out of their so that they buy. Oh, yeah, very true. So I'll tell you, yes, so you need to restrict all these gadgets, playing, PlayStation and PSP and tablet, and there's new thing in market called as PUBG. You need to restrict your child from playing all these violent games because they tend to make your child violent. So you need to set rules. You need to sit with your own husband or individual wife, sit and discuss how you're going to plan rules for your child so that, at the end of the day, you both don't, end up fighting and your child is just doing nothing but crying, being cranky and nagging. If the child is complaining about a particular, food or something, make sure that you try to inculcate it in such a way that they like it tasty. Make it very tasty for them. If the child is not having milk, try to, give it in the form of a smoothie or something. So make that food yummy for your child. Try to do that. Limit the screen time. I'm again and again repeating. Set the time to at least like say 30, 60 or more than, even if you want more, not more than 90 minutes of screen. Screen mein sab aa gaya, phone aa gaya, iPad aa gaya, tablet aa gaya, sab kuch aa gaya. Limit the screen time. Because see, your child is going to continuously, keep his eyes in front of the TV, and once that is the routine, your child will ask for food when he's watching. Because see, when our mind is ideal, we just tend to keep on eating something or the other. Hi Vishal. So guys, you need to understand, when your child is watching television, when your child is playing something, that eating pattern, set timings. I'm not saying just be a very strict parent, be a disciplined one and set timings, but set a timetable for yourself in your mind so that way your child goes according to it. I do remember we used to have homemade snacks like fried ones, like potato chips, masala puri, and homemade snacks like food. But at that time we were so slim and healthy. So Krina, it was like a period, okay? Right now also our kids do crave. So instead of giving them foods from outside, let's try and make all those yummy and healthy stuff at home. I'm requesting y'all, instead of giving your child a Frankie outside, I'm going to tell you right now a healthy version of Frankie kaise banta hai. you know, you just need to skip on the maida, the refined flour, take whole wheat flour, combine it with half amount of oats flour, okay? Knead a dough with using curds. I'm going to repeat the whole thing again. Take whole wheat flour and take oats flour in 50-50 proportion. Knead the dough in curds. Do not use water. Add flax seeds and ajwain to the roti to enhance oats ka fiber, whole wheat flour ka fiber, the nutrients from it. Mixed with the flax seeds ka omega 3, which is very beneficial, very healthy. Curd ka aapko calcium, curd ka protein. So that whole roti itself is like a whole bunch of nutrients in itself. Uske andar the patty, make that patty of paneer. Add only one potato in front of 100 grams of paneer. So that's going to balance it. So aisa nahi ki you don't need or you have to skip on the potato part of it. Add whichever veggies you like. You know, just if your child is not eating, just grind it, just crush it, or just, you know, simply mash it and add it. Make it like a tikki, and to bind the tikki, you can add oats also. Add whichever, you know, add good amount of spices, good amount of frankie masala to it. Make like a tikki. Just simply shallow fry it in a little bit of oil or ghee, and add little bit, you know, make it colorful. So whatever sauces you're adding, instead of adding a ketchup, try to add a hunker dip. Curd ko thoda, you know, hang karke and you remove the water. Add little bit of mint in it. So green color ka achha khasa dip ban jayega. Just spread it, add that tikki on it, roast it, you know, just make it shallow fry it. Give that to your kid. It is like an on the go mix of all the vital nutrients. Everything comes in that meal. Tiffin mein ye de do. So your kid is not going to crave for outside frankie. This is just one variety, one version of what I'm trying to say. There are so many healthier alternatives which can be yummy also. Instead of filling your dabbas, kids dabbas with chips, fill it with makhanas. Try to bake vegetable chips at home. Try to bake sweet potato and potato chips at home. I'm not saying you can, you know, off your kids. Don't limit, don't restrict. Aapko pata hai ice cream chocolate bura hai, but chips aur chivda bhi bura hai. Ice cream chocolate agar aap de rahe ho, to limit, restrict. Don't use all these stuff as a gift to your child. Don't use, don't make it as a reward. Instead, give it when once in a while you're eating, you can share it with your child. You know, develop an idea of sharing all these unhealthy foods so that whenever your child is eating, he will or she will have an idea. They will share all that food. So, you know, it is divided amongst their own circle. Even outside food was once in a month only when it was a birthday or something. Exactly, yes. So, you know, if your kids have an habit of going to parties, you know, try to arrange for those healthy types of parties. Try to arrange for a salad party or maybe a pot party with healthy dishes. Try to come up with all these innovative ideas. Go take your child to a healthy baking class. Take your child to a healthy, you know, going to maybe a healthy cooking class. Make that, inculcate those habits. It is in your hands. You can't blame your child. You can't blame your child. Is, you know, you can't just be telling the teachers or the students or anybody saying, "Arey, mera bacha to sabka dekh ke kar raha hai." No, it is in your hands how to handle, how to tackle your children. Yes, I know it's a wonderful recipe. You can try this and send me pictures also on my arena. So guys, this is what I wanted to, you know, bring in light about childhood obesity, to explain you all how to cover this up, because this is becoming a very, very, very important topic these days. I see children out of nowhere not concentrating on their studies, not concentrating on their career. They're just doing nothing but just simply, you know, playing in gadgets, playing. They've completely forgotten about outdoor sports. I know, guys, you want your kids to get the best of everything, but guys, you need to limit, you need to restrict at some point of time. It's going to help your child, you know, to maintain a healthy lifestyle on a longer run. That's only what I want to say for today. Apart from that, I also wanted to tell y'all, there's a lot of viral going on right now. So please try to, you know, this is beyond the topic which I'm trying to say, but a lot of viral fever is going on these days. Simple tips I wanted to give y'all. Please boil your water before drinking the water. If you feel there's a viral infection, simply just see your doctor, because there is a lot of dengue cases, you know, we are coming across. And if your platelet counts are low, please don't try to cure the dengue at home. Go to a doctor directly, see your doctor, go to a hospital, get yourself admitted, because this is going bad and we're seeing a lot of deaths due to dengue. Second thing, please have boiled water. Please cook your food in boiled water, okay? Whatever you're eating outside junk, try to avoid the outside junk. Cook all that at home fresh. Do not have anything raw in this season. Try to have a lot of yellow turmeric, which is available in this season and which is very good. You know, you can just boil it and you can simply add in your milk and have it. So try to have all these stuff in this season. Give all this stuff to your kids, which is very important. If you don't like milk in any form, try to have curds, which is going to give you natural calcium and protein. Okay, so Krina says she has a nice recipe in roti noodles. How to share, because I can't type so much here. Krina, you can just, you know, if it would be lovely if you could make it and share it. We could, you know, help. We could just make a video and share it on the arena if you want. Hi, Javed. And it would be better if you would type it. I would try to, you know, show that recipe to everybody. Okay, so guys, we, you know, are signing off for the day. So these were some tips and tricks to take care of your children, you know, preventing childhood obesity from an earlier age. And yes, these were some ideas. Please abhi khud ka dhyan rakho, season bahut hi kharab hai. So take care of yourself and take care of your family and others. So this is me, Kejal Sheth, signing off for the day. If you have anything, just leave a text on my arena. I would be happy to help you. And Monday, please be on time. I'm going to see you all at 8 sharp on my GOQii live video. And please, please, please do not forget to subscribe my video, which is just like on right hand side of your phone. And please share lots and lots of love to me. Thanks a lot, guys. Thanks a lot for being there. All right. See you. Enjoy your weekend. Have a happy and a healthy weekend. In case you guys